Okay, unit 13, complex sentence, adjective, adverb, and noun clauses. Okay, a complex sentence has one main clause and one or more dependent clauses. If you still remember, last week we have compound sentences, which mean one subject and one verb, okay? Or it can be more than one subject or one verb, but we separate it, okay? We separate them using conjunction and but or. With complex sentence, we have one main clause or one or more dependent clauses, okay? In Indonesia, we call it satu kalimat utama, ya. Satu kalimat utama dan satu kalimat dependent yang tidak bisa berdiri sendiri itu, ya. Nah, ini di bahasa Indonesia, ya. One main clause and one or more dependent clauses, ya. Jadi dependent clauses ini tidak bisa berdiri sendiri tanpa adanya main clause, oke? Okay? Nah, a dependent clause has its own subject and verb, ya. But it cannot stand by itself because the information in the clause is subordinate. Jadi kalau kalian masih ingat anak kalimat itu loh, dependent clauses itu maksudnya anak kalimat, ya. Nah, main clause itu kalimat utamanya. Kalau kalian dulu pernah ingat waktu bahasa Indonesia, anak kalimat itu kan tidak bisa berdiri sendiri. Ya, itulah yang dimaksud dengan dependent clause atau dependent clauses. In the relation, okay, in relation to the main clause, dependent clause may function as an adjective, adverb, or noun, and so the clause is named after its function. Jadi fungsi ya dari dependent clause tersebut atau anak kalimat itu, there are three functions. Kemungkinan ada tiga, nantinya akan ada tiga fungsi, bisa sebagai adjective, ya. It can become adjective clause, adverb clause, or noun clause, ya. Clause kata sifat, kata keterangan, atau kata benda, ya. Yes. Nah, kita lihat dulu ya contohnya. Oke, okay. Relative pronoun. Kita mulai dari adjective clause dulu, ya. Adjective clause, jadi clause kata sifat, ya. Yang menerangkan kata menggunakan kata sifat, ya. Okay. Adjective clause is a dependent clause that modifies noun or pronoun, ya. Seperti yang Miss Amel pernah bilang di awal-awal, adjective itu digunakan untuk modify or describe more a noun or pronoun. Jadi penggunaan adjective itu digunakan untuk menjelaskan noun, kata benda atau pronoun, ya, kata ganti. Nah, kalau adjective clause di sini nantinya digunakan sebagai modifying atau mendeskripsikan ini, ya, refer to as the antecedent. Okay, comes immediately after it and it is connected to the main clause using a relative pronoun or relative adverb. Okay, contohnya seperti ini. Anybody who has no ticket may not enter the stadium. A man that lies to other men may also lie to you. William, whom may we have talked about, will visit me next week. I like the book which you gave me as a birthday present. They have found the key and repeated the board. Okay, so in here, there are relative pronouns. There are, it could be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 with that. Yeah. As you can see here, yeah, there are... there is one main clause and one dependent clause. Miss Amel will show you. So for the first sentence, one main clause, if you still remember, one subject and one verb. So the subject is anybody, and the verb is this one. Okay, may not enter the stadium. Okay, and then who has no ticket is the adjective clause. Okay, I will put it in AC here. Why? Because adjective clause here is used to, okay, is used to digunakan untuk menerangkannya, is used to modify a noun. Okay, sesuai dengan definisinya di sini, to modify a noun. So which one is the noun, everyone? Nah, di sini noun-nya yang mana? Nah, adjective clause di sini kan digunakan untuk menerangkan noun. Di sini noun-nya yang mana? Atau pronoun? Dari kalimat pertama dulu di the first sentence. Which one is the noun or pronoun yang digunakan untuk menjelaskan ini? Anyone can answer? So the noun or pronoun is actually a anybody. So this is the now. So anybody who has no ticket may not enter the stadium. So using who, that, whom, which, that, and whose is like when we use the word yang. In Indonesia we call it yang. Jadi setiap orang yang tidak memiliki tiket tidak diperbolehkan masuk stadium. Ya, jadi penggunaan who atau who has no ticket atau relative pronoun di sini itu sama kegunaannya seperti kalau kita bahasa Indonesia yang menerangkan keterangan. Ya. Oke, kita coba lagi ya. Let's try again with number two. Oke, kita coba nomor dua sekarang. A man that lies to other men may also lie to you. Oke, so which one is the subject and noun? Wait, which one is the subject and noun? For the second examples here.
Man.
A man, yes. And which one is the subject? Sorry, a noun. Which one is the noun?
That lies to other men.
Okay, so actually man and it can be the noun as well. Yeah. Okay. And then how about the verb? Which one is the verb, everybody? Which one is the verb? That lies to other men or may also lie to you? Which one is the verb?
That lies to other men.
Are you sure? A man that lies to other men may also lie to you. So the verb is this one. Remember, every time you found this, ya, setiap kali kalian menemukan ini, itu selalu dipisahkan dengan kata yang sebelah kiri. Ya, jadi relative pronoun itu ya dipisahkan dengan lima kata ini, for these five words, okay, to show or to modify the subject or noun. Okay? And then next we have William. Okay, William is also the subject. Oh, sorry, it's not verb, sorry. That lies to other men, it's supposed to be adjective clause. Okay, the adjective clause. Yeah. This is, okay. William is the subject. The verb is, which one is the verb, everyone?
Will visit me next week.
Will visit me next week, okay. William, whom we have talked about, will visit me next week. So whom here, it's the adjective.
Adjective clause.
Adjective clause, the same. It's the same with number three. I like the book which you gave me as a birthday present. The book is the subject, okay? And then which, it's actually the book is the object, I is the subject, okay? So the book here, it's the object, okay? Which you gave me is the adjective clause, okay? The adjective clause to modify book or to describe more about the book, okay? Oh, sorry, which you, sorry, to be which you. Which you gave me as a birthday present. Yeah, okay. So which you gave me as a birthday present is the adjective clause. And you can put the verb at the beginning. Okay, so actually you can put the adjective clause at the middle, okay, in the middle of the sentence or at the back. Okay, just like the sentence at number four. Okay. They have found the book. Sorry, they have found the key that you are looking for. So it's the same like number four. So we have this subject, and have found is the verb, and the key is the noun that you are looking for is the adjective clause. Okay, so I want you to just remember, okay, mohon diingat ya, jika ada kata yang diawali dengan that, which, whom, atau who, ya, dia itu digunakan untuk menerangkan noun sebelumnya, ya, sebelum kata tersebut, ya. We pitied the boy, ya, this is we is the subject, pitied is the verb, the boy is noun, whose mother was arrested for the theft. Okay, so this one is adjective clause. Okay, I want you to remember, okay, please remember that every time you use whose, that, which, whom, and who, put the noun exactly next to the relative pronouns. Oke, jadi ditulisnya pas di sebelahnya relative pronouns tersebut, pas di sebelahnya ya. Karena apa? Kalian bisa lihat contohnya di sini ya. Jadi di sini ya. Jadi langsung menjelaskan sebelahnya ya. Langsung menjelaskan sebelahnya seperti ini ya. Tidak jauh-jauh ya seperti ini. Oke. Kira-kira seperti itu ya. Nanti kita lihat contohnya di strategi ya untuk latihan lebih lanjut. Oke. Now let's move on to relative adverb. Sorry. So relative adverb, I think it's much more for me I think it's much more obvious. Okay, so there are only three: where, when, and why. So we use them to show. Where is used to show the location. Okay, so where is to show the location. And then when is to show the time. Okay, and why is to show the reason. Okay, so this is the example. The town where I was born is far away. That will be the time when I will carry out my plans. We do not know the reason why he left his wife and children. Okay, so this is the example. I think I will try to give you one more example here. Let's see, I will give you one more example and I want you to answer it, try to answer it using where, when, or why, okay? Okay, so I want you to fill the blanks here. Do we use where, when, or why?
Why?
Why? Okay.
Where?
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 Hmm?
Where?
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 Where? Where? Good job, everyone. Where? So, Aulia, can you give me a reason why you choose where? You choose where? Sorry. Why you answer with where? Why you answer with where?
Because. The last sentence is here.
Hmm?
So that means talk about location of the topic.
Location, okay. Are you sure? Because if we use where, okay, so this is a bit of a trap actually. If we use where, okay, we have no idea where Jack left his jacket here. Kita nggak tahu di mana Jack meletakkan jaketnya di sini. Is it correct? Kan kita udah tahu nih tempatnya.
Oh, right? Yeah.
So this is my trap to you actually here. So it's not where everyone. So any other answer perhaps? We have no idea.
Why?
Why? It's actually why, okay? So we have no idea why Jack left his jacket here. Jadi kita tidak tahu mengapa Jack meletakkan jaketnya di sini. Okay. Or we can say when as well. Ya, kita bisa ganti dengan when juga. Ya, we have no idea when Jack left his jacket here. Ya, kita kan cuma tahu tempatnya doang ya, lokasinya. Tapi kita tidak tahu alasannya mengapa dan juga waktunya. Ya, when Jack left his jacket here. Jadi kapan dia menaruh jaketnya di sini? Ya, bisa hari ini, besok atau gimana? Ya. Jadi untuk yang relative adverbs ini tergantung dari nanti kalian lihat contohnya. Ya. Oke. Okay. Right. So now let's move on to the next one. Oke. Okay. Oke. Okay, let's move on to the next one. I will scroll it down. You can also scroll it down. Okay, so we have strategies here. Okay, so now let's try to okay, circle the relative pronouns and underline the nouns they modify. Decide which ones are wrong, correct the mistakes. Okay, now let's start with the circling first, everyone. Okay, so now circle the relative pronouns. Okay, do you still remember the relative pronouns? Who, that, and then? Whom,
which
and
that
That finish. One more is whose. Okay, whose. You can always scroll it up there to check. Okay, the woman who you just talked to is my aunt. Okay, so which one is the relative pronouns, everyone? Which one? Relative pronouns ya tadi, aman. It's this one. Who? Yes. I need to change the color first. Yeah, who? And then underline the nouns they modify. Okay, sekarang which one is the nouns to modify who you just talked to?
The woman.
The woman. Okay, the woman who you just talked to is my aunt. Okay. Is it correct or not? What do you think? Do we use the relative pronoun correctly? Apakah kita pakai who? Benar apa enggak? Okay, so it's actually incorrect. So we change who with whom. Ya. Yeah. Di sini mungkin ada yang tahu bedanya perbedaan who sama whom? Ada yang tahu enggak bedanya? So, I will explain here. So, we use who, kita pakai who untuk subject, ya. Lalu whom untuk object, ya. Contohnya seperti ini. Misalnya akan beri contoh di sini. Tony, I will make Tony, ya. Who is a chef? Oh, sorry. Tony who loves his wife, okay, is a chef. Okay. Jadi kenapa di sini subjek? Karena Tony di sini adalah orang yang mencintai sepedanya dan juga sebagai chef. Ya. Sekarang kalian coba lihat perbedaannya di kalimat kedua, ya. Tony whom I met last week is a chef. Ya, misalnya samakan saja. Ya, coba kalian lihat bedanya. Ya. Tony di sini Tony yang kedua kan sebagai objek. Karena apa? Kalimatnya bisa dilihat di sini yang pertama ya. Tony whom I met last week ya. Jadi I met him last week ya. Di sini kalian bisa lihat ya. Nah, di sini maksudnya I met him last week ya, kata him di sini untuk apa memodify Tony ya. Tony who loves his bike is a chef ya. Okay, now let's try to use whose ya. Kalau whose itu kan kepemilikan, contohnya seperti ini, kita bisa ganti gini. Tony whose bike was stolen is a chef. Ya, seperti ini. Ya, ini kepemilikan Tony yang sepedanya dicuri adalah chef. Ya. Sekarang kita coba yang ini ya, kita coba yang nomor 2. Okay. Now, which one is the relative pronouns? Everyone, David who created the most beautiful painting has won the first prize. So, which one is the relative pronouns, everyone? Can I circle it? Nomor 2. It's who, okay? Who, and then which one is the noun?
David.
It's David. Okay, David who created the most beautiful painting has won the first prize. So I want you to pay attention to my examples about Tony. So do you think it's correct or not?
Or not? Correct.
It's already correct. Very good, because David is the person who has won the prize and also created the most beautiful painting. Okay. All right, so it's stable. Okay, let's move on to number 3. Okay. Which one is the relative pronoun?
Whom.
Whom, all right, it's whom. And then which one is the noun that modified whom? Okay, remembers?
The students.
The students, good. Jadi mohon diingat ya, penggunaan whom ya, relative pronoun di sini tuh selalu bersebelahan dengan noun yang diterangkan ya. Jadi kalau kalian mau cari noun yang mana, tinggal kalian lihat di sisi sebelah kiri ya. Oke, sekarang kita lihat the biology teacher failed one of the students whom cheated. Is it correct or not? Nah, coba bisa dilihat ya, who or that to modify a person as a subject. Nah, kalau whom untuk objeknya. Kira-kira sudah betul belum? Sekarang kalian lihat student-nya. Student-nya di sini sebagai subjek atau objek? Is it supposed to be whom or who, everyone? Okay. So it's actually incorrect. Okay, jadi di sini kita hapus M-nya ya. So it's actually the biology teacher failed one of the students who cheated. Okay, who cheated. Jadi siswanya tersebut yang menyontek, ya. Yeah. I will give you one tip, okay? Penggunaan who dan whom, ya. Yeah. Misalnya kasih satu tips ya untuk bedain who sama whom, ya. Yeah. Kalian lihat baik-baik nomor 1 dan 2 di sini, ya. Yeah. Kalian lihat baik-baik relative pronouns ya. Please pay attention to the relative pronouns here. Before, when I ask you to look for the noun, you look here, right? Kalian kan kalau tadi pas bisa Mel tanya yang mana noun-nya, kalian lihat sebelah sini. Nah, kalau kalian mau membedakan penggunaan who dan whom, ya, I want you to look after the relative pronoun. Oke? Okay? I want you to look after the relative pronoun. Pay attention carefully. What is the difference between who and whom after this? Nah, apa perbedaannya? Biasanya ya, kalau whom, kalau who, biasanya setelah relative pronoun-nya itu langsung verb. Oke, okay? Langsung verb. Tetapi kalau whom, setelahnya whom biasanya apa ini? Pronoun. Ya, kembali ke pronoun I, you, he, she, they. Seperti itu. Ya. Nah, di sini kalian bisa lihat contohnya. Nah, ini pakai pakai whom, yang ini pakai who karena langsung verb, yang ini juga pakai who. Oke. Okay. Nah, let's try with number 4, oke? Okay? So, let's start with number 4. Which one is the relative pronoun, everyone?
Who.
Who.
Very good. Wait. who. Okay, who. And then which one is the noun?
Stephen.
It's Stephen. Okay, so do you think it's correct or not? Remember? My tip.
Incorrect, ma'am.
Incorrect. It's
incorrect.
Supposed to be?
Whom.
Whom. Okay, now you get it, right? After whom, yeah. It's subject, right? Subject or pronoun. I, you, they, we, he, she, it, right? Mm-hmm, like that. Nice work, everyone. That's the biggest step, I guess, that I can give to you. To differentiate between who and whom. Ya, untuk membedakan who sama whom. Ya. Now let's move on to number 5, last one. In the bank, I met a woman who kept staring at me suspiciously. So which one is the relative pronoun?
Who.
Who. Mm-hmm. The noun?
A woman.
A woman.
A woman. Okay, is it correct or not, everyone?
Correct, ma'am.
Correct.
It's correct. Good job. So after who, as you can see here, it's the verb. Okay, it's the verb. Nice job, everyone. Very good. Okay, so every time later you, when you need to choose later in the test, when you need to choose between who or whom, just pay attention to the next word here. Is it verb or is it pronoun? Okay, is it verb or is it pronoun? If it is verb, choose who. If it is pronoun, choose whom. Okay, whom, just like number 4. Okay, any questions before I scroll it down?
Not yet, ma'am.
Not yet. Okay, it's okay. We will take this unit slowly because there are 3 clauses here and we have just jumped into the first clause, which is adjective clause, okay? Now let's see. Wait, have you done that? Have you done screenshotting? Wait, can I undo it? Okay, you can always screenshot this one to know more about it. Yeah, terus, and then we have, I think I need to, yeah. Okay, finish? Can I clear it all?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I will clear them all first, okay? Okay, now let's see the sample item here. Okay, Leonardo da Vinci, who many consider, okay, nah, because this is supposed to be whom, because many consider, itu kan banyak orang yang, many, itu kan many people, ya, jadi di sini many people, maksudnya banyak orang yang menganggap dia sebagai father of modern drawing, ya, jadi many people atau subject, ya, kalau bukan verb di sini berarti kita otomatis pakai whom, ya. Oke. Okay. Sorry. Now let's see strategy to everyone. Okay. On strategy one, we have discussed about the difference between who and whom. Okay, who is for the subject and whom is for the object. And I have given you the tips on how to differentiate it. And remember, you use who and whom only for, are only for human, okay, for people. And we go on or we move to which or that, okay? You use pronoun which or that to modify a thing, either as a subject or an object, ya. Jadi penggunaan which atau that di sini tidak ada pembeda antara dia ini subjek atau object, bukan. Tapi yang perlu diingat hanya satu, which atau that digunakan untuk memodify benda, ya, non-human, yang bukan manusia. A chair, a bottle, animal, pet, ya, books, okay, books, table, TV, cell phone, things, okay. Jadi non-animate, sorry, inanimate object, jadi yang non-human. Okay, let's try with number one. As usual, circle the relative pronouns first and underline. All right, number one. How about if I try one by one? Okay. Okay, let's try. Can I have Sulaiman? Number one, Sulaiman. Which one,
yes, ma'am,
the relative pronouns? I will circle it for you.
That.
That. Okay. Which one is the noun?
The books.
The books. Okay, now I want you to pay attention to the sentence. Is it correct or not?
Correct, ma'am.
Correct. Good job. Thank you, Sulaiman. Next, number two. Sulaiman, you can choose your friend.
Rizal Dwi.
Ooh, Rizal Dwi. Okay, Rizal, please turn on your sound.
Okay, miss.
Okay, Rizal, which one is the relative pronoun?
Relative pronoun.
Oh, number two, number two.
Whom.
Whom, all right. And then which one is the noun that modifies it?
Brian.
Okay. Are you sure? Brian, remember, next to the relative pronoun?
The car.
The car, very good. Jadi, langsung, ya, jadi noun-nya itu langsung pas di sebelahnya, ya, pas. Okay, now pay attention to the sentence. Is it correct or not? Brian wants to buy the car whom he saw at the exhibition yesterday. Is it correct or not?
Correct, miss.
Hmm? Are you sure? Do we use whom to modify the car?
Yes.
Okay, it's actually in?
Incorrect.
Incorrect. Okay, we cannot use who or whom to modify or to explain more about a thing. Seperti yang tadi udah Miss Amel bilang, penggunaan who atau whom hanya untuk manusia, people, ya. Sedangkan mobil atau the car itu bukan. Itu kan a thing, benda. Jadi kita ganti dengan
that.
That, very good. That, good. Ya, kayak gini, ya. Jadi Brian wants to buy the car that he saw at the exhibition yesterday. Jadi jangan pakai ini, ya, jangan pakai whom, ya, karena bukan manusia. Next, Rizal, you can choose your friend for number three.
Fajar, Mas Fajar.
Fajar, okay, Fajar.
Yes, Miss.
Okay, Fajar, which one is the relative pronoun here?
That.
That, okay. Which one is the noun, sorry?
The train.
The train crash, okay. Yes. The train crash, is it correct or not?
Is correct.
Correct. Okay, good. Jadi the train crash ini ya atau tabrakan kereta api itu bisa dianggap sebagai a thing ya. Kejadian itu atau event bisa juga dianggap sebagai a thing atau benda ya. Good. Thank you, Fajar. Fajar, you can choose your friend for number four.
Brian.
Okay, Brian.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I have you in here. Okay. How about number four, Brian? Which one is the relative pronoun here? I borrowed the book. Who was
recommended? I borrowed the book. Who was recommended by Professor Anthony?
Mm-hmm.
So the pronoun is actually who.
Who?
And but the noun is the book.
The book.
Okay. But since the book is not a human, so that's incorrect. So we must use that. To change the who.
Correct. Good. That. Okay. Very good. Thank you, Brian. So yes. Everyone, if you want to use which, it's also correct. Okay. Jadi kalau kalian miss, ganti which. Karena ini artinya sama. Which or that itu sama. Ya, sama-sama betul. Ya. Which atau that itu betul, ya? Yeah? Oke, okay, thank you, Brian. Brian, now yes. can you choose your friend for the last number?
Alvinda lah, ya.
Oke, okay, Alvinda, are you here?
Yes, I'm here.
Oke, okay. Wait, Alvinda. oke, okay. Alvinda, which one is the relative pronoun?
The related pronoun is whom, but that is incorrect.
Mm-hmm. Which one is the noun, sorry?
And the noun is the football match.
Very good. So, because you said it's incorrect, so how do we change that?
The related pronoun is which or that.
Which or that. Very good. You can choose one for this one, okay? Which or that. Okay. That's it, everyone. Thank you. So, this is the correct answers. You can always screenshot it. And, oh yeah. I will give you a note here. So which is used to modify thing, okay, whether if it is subject or object, okay. But that, okay, if you find that is a very flexible, actually, that is a very flexible pronoun because you can use that to change who, whom, and which, okay? So for example, like before, if you change whom into that, it's already correct, but when you use that, it's kind of like informal expression, okay? Jadi penggunaan that itu sebenarnya bisa ditaruh di whom, who, atau which, tapi nanti jadinya informal. Dan kebanyakan di TOEFL test itu biasanya dilarang penggunaannya untuk that, untuk semua ini. Ya, jadi kalian harus ingat baik-baik penggunaan who, perbedaan who, whom, dan which. Diingat ya, kalau which itu khusus untuk benda. Tapi kalian tidak perlu pusing karena which itu bisa digunakan bendanya itu entah itu sebagai subjek atau objek. Ya, pokoknya kalian ingat-ingat aja which itu untuk benda, who dan whom itu untuk human, manusia. He, she, they itu pakai who atau whom. Cuma perbedaannya penempatannya aja. Who itu untuk subjek, whom itu untuk objek. Dan tadi sudah misalnya kasih tips ya, membedakan penggunaan who dan whom selain subjek dan objek, yaitu lihat di sebelahnya ya, look at the next word. If it is verb, kalau setelah verb, kalau setelahnya itu verb, titik-titik verb itu kita pakai who, tapi kalau setelahnya subjek atau noun, itu kita pakai whom, ya, kira-kira seperti itu. Okay, finish everyone. Can I scroll it down? Ada yang mau ditanyakan untuk strategi 2? So, can I move on? Sudah selesai?
Yes, ma'am.
Ada yang mau ditanyakan mungkin atau misalnya bisa lanjutkan? Hello.
Lanjut,
saya lanjut, Miss.
Oke, misalnya lanjut ya. Nah, sekarang kita lanjut ke strategi tiga. Tentu saja, selanjutnya strategi tiga itu, this one, can be seen from what are, okay. Jadi, di sini yang salah adalah what ya, seharusnya kita ganti dengan that or which. Ya. Tidak ada what di sini. Ya. Nah, sekarang kita ke yang nomor tiga. Nah, ini mungkin ya bisa dijadikan contoh tadi yang contohnya relative adverb. Where, when, and why. Ya. Diingat, where itu untuk tempat. Ya, place, location, when to a time expression, jam ya, yesterday, tomorrow, 2 hours ago, next year, ya pokoknya waktu. Why to reason, ya, why we have no idea why you left us, for example, like that. Okay, okay. Now because the last one is Alvinda. Nah, Alvinda, can you choose your friend, yeah, to try to answer number one for strategy three, okay?
Aulia.
Aulia. Okay. Aulia, are you here?
Yeah.
Okay. Now Aulia, let's start with number one. Now Aulia, which one is the relative pronoun first?
The pronoun is why.
Why? Okay. The reason why. Okay. Which one is the noun? Mm-hmm.
The reason.
The reason. Okay. So I want you to see the sentence here. Is it correct or not?
I think it's already correct.
Very good. It's already correct. Okay. Because number one is to show the reason. Okay, why she did not come to your party because she was busy writing her paper. Jadi nomor satu sudah kelihatan jelas bahwa itu merupakan alasan, ya. Okay, thank you, Aulia. Aulia, now you can choose your friend to answer number two.
Hamid, Miss.
Hamid, okay, Hamid, can you turn on your sound, Hamid? Hamid, hello. All right, I think Hamid is still up here. Alvinda, sorry, Aulia, can you choose other? I think Hamid is still out.
Rizal Fatur, Mas.
Rizal Fatur, okay, Rizal, you here?
Yes, Miss.
Okay, now Rizal, let's answer number two. Rizal, which one is the relative pronoun?
Which.
Which, okay. And then which one is the noun?
German University.
A German University, okay. So is it correct or not?
That's incorrect.
Okay, how do we change it?
Which change to where?
Which change to?
Where.
Okay, good. Because a German university is a?
A place.
A place, very good. A place or a location. Okay, a place. Good. Thank you. Rizal, you can choose your friend now to answer number three. Yeah, Rizal, you can choose your friend for number three. To answer number three.
Bagas.
Bagas, okay. Bagas. Okay, Bagas, hello. Can you turn on your sound? Hello, is Bagas here? Okay. I think Bagas is still out. Rizal, can you choose others?
Alvin.
Alvin, okay. Alvin, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Alvin, let's check number three. Please pay attention to number three. Which one is the related pronoun?
When.
When, all right. And then which, which one is the noun that modifies it?
A museum.
A museum, okay. Is it correct or not?
No.
Nope, it's incorrect. So how do you change it?
Where.
Where, okay, because a museum is a place, okay, the same like a German university. So my father took me to a museum where he showed me a very rare species of flower. Okay, thank you, Alvin. Alvin, you can choose your friend.
Habibi, ma'am.
Habibi, okay, Habibi. Can you turn on your sound, I guess? Are you ready? Okay, Habibi. Okay, Habibi, number four. Habibi, which one is the relative pronoun? A market is a place when buyers and sellers meet for business dealings. So which one is the relative pronoun, Habibi? Oh, the relative pronoun, is it a place or when? A place or when? A relative pronoun. Relative pronoun-nya dulu ya, ini yang bisa melingkarin. A place or when? Relative pronoun yang tadi yang for W's, one T. Ya. Who, whom, where, when. Okay, and then which one is the noun that modifies it? Nah, sekarang noun-nya yang mana? Yang digunakan. Tuh. Yang dimodifikasi sama when ini. Which one? Remember, relative pronoun, and then before it, which one, Habibi? A market is a place when buyers and sellers meet for business dealings. Okay. A market or a place? So look at the example on number 1, number 2, and then number 3. So before, exactly before the relative pronoun actually, okay? So it's a place, ya. Yeah? Jadi noun-nya itu letaknya itu pas di sebelahnya, ya, di sebelahnya relative pronoun-nya. Jadi kenapa letaknya langsung di sebelahnya? Karena langsung menjelaskan. Kalau misalkan sebelahnya itu bukan noun-nya, bukan noun-nya, kayak masih verb-nya atau adverb, itu berarti kalian salah. Ya, jadi sebelumnya relative pronoun itu wajib kalian taruh noun-nya. Ya, karena apa? Noun itu digunakan untuk menjelaskan. Makanya dinamakan adjective clause. Ya, adjective clause itu digunakan untuk menjelaskan atau modifikasi noun. Ya, jadi langsung noun sebelahnya. Oke. Nah, now Habibi, please pay attention carefully. Sekarang coba dilihat baik-baik ya. A market is a place when buyers and sellers meet for business dealings. Is it already correct or not? If it is incorrect, how do we correct it? How do you correct it? Okay, very good. So it's not correct. So we change when with where, because a market is a place where. It's a place, actually, it's a place. Okay, thank you, Habibi. Next, Habibi, can you choose your friend? I think everyone has answered here. Okay, yeah, Habibi, you can choose your friend then. Okay, Sulaiman. Okay, Sulaiman, number 5, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, number 5, Sulaiman. Which one is the relative pronoun?
Where.
Where? The noun?
The noun is on Sunday.
On Sunday. Is it correct or not?
It's incorrect, ma'am. We can change where it's supposed to be when.
Okay, so we have only one when here. Why do you think we should change it with when, Sulaiman?
Yes, ma'am.
Because we change it into when? Because
there is explain about time.
It's about time. So the time is on
Sunday.
On Sunday. Very good. So the time here on Sunday. Okay, good job. Any questions? Any questions about using where, when, and why? It's really obvious here in the sentences here. Okay, so you can screenshot it first. Okay, you can screenshot it first and then we can continue. Okay. Finish everyone?
Yes, miss.
Okay, finish screenshot. Okay, I will scroll it down first. So I have checked this, okay. In California, the transverse ranges increase in elevation toward the east when Mount San Gorgonio rises to 3,506 meters above sea level. The sample item is incorrect. The incorrect one is B, because noun is a place, okay? The east, arah timur ya, it's not when, bukan time, but it's a location. So we change it into where. Ya. Jadi kalau location atau tempat kita ganti where, when itu untuk waktu, why untuk reason. Okay? So now I will stop share for a while. Okay, let's continue with this one. Now let's scroll it down. I want you to scroll it down to adverb clauses, okay? So A, before we have adjective clauses. Jadi sebelumnya kita punya adjective clauses yang digunakan untuk memodify, to modify noun. But adverb clause, yeah, is a dependent clause that modifies a verb, adjective, or adverb. Ya, jadi penggunaan adverb clause digunakan untuk menjelaskan a verb, ya, kata kerja, adjective, kata sifat, bahkan adverb sendiri, ya, kata keterangan. Ya, so that in main clause, somebody said, okay, jadi kegunaan, ya, kegunaan yang tadi, ya, kalau tadi kan kegunaannya bisa sebagai apa tuh banyak, ya. Time, location, reason, contrast, comparison, condition, okay, result, purpose, cause, and effect. Kalau tadi kan ada yang a place, location, ya, reason, ya. Nah, an adverb clause may come at the beginning, in the middle, or at the end of the sentence. Okay, a comma is needed. Nah, first three types of adverb clauses. Okay. with this one, I guess you have familiar with this, yeah. Adverb clause of time, adverb clause of place, adverb clause of reason. Oke, okay? Jadi kalau kalian menemukan ini, ya ini digunakan untuk adverb clause ya. Jadi so it used to show time, place, and reason because it read. And remember, okay, when you put the adverb clause in the middle, you do not need to put any comma. But when you put it in the beginning, just like this, until we save enough money, comma, we won't start a family. Then, wherever I go, comma, people are suspicious. The match was canceled because it rained heavily. Okay, you can write adverb clauses here whenever you can. You can put the adverb clause in the middle, just like this example. Or you can put it at the beginning. But remember, when you put this adverb clause in the beginning, remember to put comma. So I will make an example. Okay, jadi Miss Amel akan kasih contoh ketika ditaruh di depan. Contohnya seperti, Miss Amel kasih contoh yang ini dulu ya, Jackie. So before she leaves, comma, Jackie wants to see you. Okay, that's the time, adverb clause of time. Okay, nah, before, after, since, when, until, yeah, as since ya. Nah, kalau untuk as ini bisa digunakan untuk dua ya, reason dan juga time ya. Now, how about if we change the adverb clause in the beginning? How about we try to put it in front? Okay. Siapa yang mau coba? Nah, misalnya kasih contoh yang ini. Wherever I go, people are suspicious. So, who wants to try? Siapa yang mau coba taruh wherever, taruh tengah? Who wants to try? You can turn on your sound. Siapa yang mau coba? Contoh yang ini. Wherever I go, people are suspicious. And then, how do you put wherever in the middle? Siapa yang mau coba?
Suleiman.
Yeah, Suleiman, okay.
Mm-hmm. People are suspicious wherever I go.
Very good. People are suspicious. Is it correct? Suspicious wherever I go. Good job. Okay, so do you put any comma, Suleiman? Any comma if you put it in the middle?
No.
No, okay. So if you put it in the middle, you do not need any comma, except if you put it in front. Remember, comma is very important if you put the adverb clause in the beginning, okay? All right, so how about we try with the strategies, okay? I think I will wear my, this one because it's a bit noisy. Okay, let's start with the strategy, okay, as usual. I will start with the strategy first and I will explain it a bit to you. Everyone, can you hear my voice? Is it clear?
Yes.
Is it yes. clear? Oh, okay, all right. Let's start doing the strategies, okay?
Strategies. I have a question.
Yeah?
What's the difference since in adverb clause of time and since at adverb clause of reason?
Ah, okay. So this is what I've been waiting for. What is the meaning of since in adverb clause of time here? He hasn't eaten anything since he arrived. Artinya apa kalau di bahasa Indonesia?
Sejak.
Ya. Kalau since yang ini untuk time ya artinya sejak. Nah, sekarang coba kita lihat yang reason. We don't know him well since he seldom talks about himself. Sorry. Nah, kalau yang since di sini kira-kira nih bisa dikira-kira. Artinya apa? We do not know him well since he seldom talks about himself.
Karena.
Yes, that's the difference. Okay? Jadi bagaimana membedakannya? Ya, bagaimana membedakan since untuk reason dan since untuk time. Kalian bisa lihat di ininya ya, nanti penjelasan di setelahnya ya. Tapi perbedaannya seperti ini. Jadi kalau kalian masih ingat pertemuan yang lalu, jadi penggunaan persamaan sinonimnya because itu kan ada tiga ya. Masih ingat nggak? Because, since, sama yang kemarin itu masih ingat nggak? Kan ada and, but, yet, or, sama apa? Kalau yang for ya. Ya, jadi ini sama artinya karena itu, tapi tergantung kalimatnya nanti ya, seperti itu Sulaiman ya. Jadi kalau misalkan Sulaiman bilang gini, "Miss, I cannot come to the class since I am sick." Nah, di situ kira-kira artinya Sulaiman menggunakan since untuk time or reason. Miss, I cannot come to the class since I am sick. Itu reason or time?
Reason.
Very good. Itu untuk reason. Kalau misalnya seperti ini. Miss, the class is postponed. Miss, the class has been postponed since last week. Kalau yang itu gimana? Is it since... this one or since this one? Miss, the class was postponed since last week. Kelasnya di
class of time.
Time, ya, sejak seperti itu ya. nanti bisa dilihat. Biasanya kalau since yang time, itu biasanya selanjutnya itu expression of time. Kebanyakannya itu waktu last week, on Sunday, two weeks ago. Biasanya seperti itu sih, Sulaiman, kalau since yang time ini. Ya. Nanti kita lihat lagi contohnya ya, biar lebih jelas ya. Kira-kira seperti itu ya, misalnya bisa jelaskan lebih jauh untuk since. Bedanya since yang time sama reason ya.
Oke,
nanti. Oke, nanti kita lihat contohnya lagi ya. Biasanya sih kalau since yang time ini, itu biasanya setelah kata since itu biasanya waktu. Entah since last week, since a year ago, biasanya sih seperti itu. Ya. Nah, itu baru kalian tahu, oh ini time, seperti itu. Oke, okay. Nah kita lihat ya. Nah, tadi kan kalian sudah, untuk strategi ini misalnya I cannot scroll it up, but later if you want to decide which one are wrong, you can always scroll up on your own book, okay? So let's start with number one. The battle was stopped temporarily when both parties declared a truce. Ya, a truce itu artinya gencatan senjata. So everyone, which one is the subordinate conjunctions here? Yang mana? Subordinate conjunctions yang mana? The bell was stopped temporarily when both parties declared a truce.
When.
Okay, when. Nah, ini cuma dilingkarin aja. So is it correct or not? Jadi penggunaannya sudah benar atau belum? Sudah penggunaan menggunakan reason, time, or place. Coba dilihat kalimatnya. Ini sudah betul belum? Time, place, or reason.
Reason.
It's reason. It's already correct actually. Yeah. When. Yeah, ketika. Ya, ketika both parties declared a truce. Ya, jadi udah betul ya. Udah betul. Very good ya. Sudah betul nih ya. It's already correct. Okay. Number two. Can I have Sulaiman then? Sulaiman. Oh, this is time and place. Use correct summative for adverb clauses of time and place. Okay, so I want you to focus on time and place. Yes, Sulaiman. So number two, which one is the subordinate conjunction?
Where.
Where, okay. Is it correct or not? So you can scroll it up there to make sure. This is for time and place. The meeting was called off where the boss suddenly got sick.
Incorrect.
Incorrect. So which one should we change it? How do we when. Change it? When. Very good. Yeah, ketika. Okay. Nice job. Thank you, Sulaiman. Okay. So you can choose your friend now for number three. It's okay. We can do it slowly and surely.
VP.
Number three is? Siapa number tiga? Sulaiman.
Oh. When.
Oh yeah, when. Okay, when. Mm-hmm. And then, is it correct or not? The school was already around when I was still 7 years old.
Correct.
Correct. Okay, it's already correct. Okay, Sulaiman, for number four, you can choose your friend, Sulaiman.
Habibi.
Habibi, okay. Habibi, are you here? Can you hear me? Okay, Habibi. Yes, okay. Now let's start with number four, Habibi. So which one is the subordinate conjunction, Habibi? Uh-huh. Okay. So is it correct? Or not. Lewis can be easily found where there are free dinners. Is it correct or not? Remember time and place, okay? Where there are free dinners. Mm-hmm. Okay. When? Okay. when there are free dinners or where there are free dinners. Actually, Louis can be easily found where there are free dinners or when there are free dinners. Dapat ditemukan di waktu atau di tempat sebenarnya. Di waktu di mana ada makan malam gratis atau di waktu ketika. Because it's dinner time. Okay. Yes, dinner time. Yeah. When? Yeah. Good. It's dinner time. Good. Thank you, Habibi. You can choose your pen, Habibi. You can choose your friend, Habibi, to answer number five. Okay. Bagas. Okay, Bagas, are you here? Hello, Bagas. I think Bagas is still out of AFK, okay, away from keyboard. Can you choose other, Habibi, I think? Bagas is still out of... Perhaps other friends to answer number five. Rizal Dwi. Okay. Rizal, are you here? Rizal Dwi?
Yes, miss.
Okay, let's answer number five. So which one is the subordinate conjunctions? Richard doesn't mind meeting you whenever you have time. Which one is supporting me?
Whatever means?
Whatever, correct. Okay, so is the sentence correct or not? Remember, it's time and place for strategy one. Richard doesn't mind meeting you whenever you have time. Is it correct or not?
Richard will... Correct.
Are you sure? Whatever. Is it time and place? Meeting, you have time?
When?
Whenever. You can always say whenever like this. Okay? Mm-hmm. Whenever. Okay? Whenever. Okay, so this is the how to differentiate using time and place. When, whenever, where, okay, where, and then since. Okay, jadi di sini cuma pakai where aja ya. Jadi untuk time-nya bisa pakai since yang tadi seperti itu ya. Alright, now I think I will clear all. Have you finished screenshotting?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay, if you have any questions later, you can always ask me. Okay, I will scroll it down. In 1698, Arabs from Oman took control of Zanzibar and developed trade there, which the Nyamwezi and Yao ethnic groups had become active. Okay, so the incorrect one is C. Okay, there, when, yeah. Kenapa di sini kita pakai when, yeah. Ini ada waktu ya, the time ya, in 1698 ya. Okay, now let's move on with sample item 2 ya. Ini adalah C ya. Carved on its surface lies where ya. Jadi lies di sini, nah di sini lies ini juga bisa juga digunakan sebagai tips ya untuk place, karena lies itu artinya terletak ya. Jadi terletak itu untuk menunjukkan lokasi atau place ya. Biasanya setelah lies itu where ya, biasanya ya, untuk gambarnya gitu ya. Nah, okay. Strategy 2, we have because of or due to. Okay. Alright. Okay. So the last one is okay. Jadi kita tidak boleh menggunakan because of atau due to untuk menjelaskan clause, adverb clause of reason. You have to use, tadi apa yang tadi? Because atau since ya. Jadi adverb clause of reason itu contohnya tadi apa? Because, since, as, lalu apa lagi tadi? Can you tell me yang tadi di atas? Adverb clause of reason apa aja tadi? Because, since, as, lalu apa lagi?
Only three.
Only three? Oh, okay. So later you can use this, okay? Because, since, and as. Okay, so last one is Rizal Dwi. Okay, Rizal, can you choose your friend to answer number one?
Rizal Fatur.
Okay, Rizal. Rizal Fatur, are you there? Hello, Rizal. Hello, Rizal, are you there?
Yes, miss.
Okay, how about number one, Rizal? So, which one is the adverb clause of reason? The workers had to stop working because there was a bomb threat at their office. Which one is the adverb clause of reason?
Clause reason. There was a bomb.
The connector. The connector.
Because.
Because. Good job. So is it correct or not?
Incorrect.
How do you change that? Is it?
Incorrect, miss.
Okay. Why is it incorrect?
It should be because of.
Look at number two here. Avoid using because of or due to in introducing an adverb clause of reason. Jadi, hindari, yeah. So it's already.
It's already correct.
It's already correct. Okay, jadi di sini ada tulisan avoid, yes. Ya, avoid. Jadi hindari penggunaan, ya. Okay, thank you. Next, Rizal, can you choose your friend for number two?
Alvin.
Alvin, okay. Alvin, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so how about number two, Alvin? Which one is the connectors, adverb connectors of reason?
Due to.
Due to, okay. Is it correct or not?
Incorrect.
Okay, how do we change that? The tennis matches were postponed due to the weather. Sorry?
Because,
correct. Because. Okay. Next, Alvin, you can choose your friend.
Aulia.
Aulia? Okay, Aulia. Let's try number three, okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So Aulia, which one is the adverb connectors of reason for number three?
Because.
Okay. Oh, sorry, my connection is a bit unstable. Okay, number three, because or because of? Here I go, goodness, on the test because of the time was off. Okay, because or because of Aulia?
Because.
Only because, okay. Not because of?
No. Yeah, because.
Okay, so is it correct or not? Okay, so is it correct or not, Aulia? Hernandez couldn't finish all the problem sentence because of the time was up. Is it correct or not?
Already correct.
Okay, so it's actually the connectors here is not only because, but because of. Yeah. Jadi connector di sini ada because of. Yeah. Nah, tapi di sini salah, kita tidak boleh pakai because of, tapi hanya pakai because. Karena apa? Setelah because, ya, biasanya setelah because itu ada subjeknya lagi, ya, biasanya noun, ya. Nah, tapi ini kan bukan. Ini kan because of baru the time was up. Seperti itu, ya. Oke? Okay? Alia? Alright, oke. Okay. Right, Aulia, you can choose your friend for number four.
Okay. Brian.
Brian, okay. Yep.
Yes.
How about number four? Which one is the adverb connector of reason?
Number four, I think it's because.
Mm-hmm.
And
it's correct or not?
It's also correct, already correct.
Mm-hmm. Okay, very good. One of our plants had to be shut down because we did not have that many orders. Okay, it's already correct. At yes. A close of reason. Thank you, Ryan. Now you can choose your plant for number five.
I choose Mas Fajar.
Okay, Fajar. Fajar, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so number five, which one is the adverb?
In class,
which one is the adverb connector of reason?
I think it's due to.
Due to? Okay, is it correct or not?
Not correct.
Not correct, okay. How do we change it, Fajar?
Because.
Because, okay, good job. Okay, so you can always change because with since or as. It's the same as which or that. Jadi artinya sama ya. Okay, good job. Thank you everyone. Jadi mohon diingat ya, ketika kalian menggunakan adverb clause of reason, jangan pakai because of or gitu ya. Jadi hanya yang ada di atas because, since, or as. Okay? Have you finished screenshotting? Then after that, Miss Amel can scroll it down. Or do you have any questions about strategy two? Any questions, everyone? Or shall I continue?
Oh, me.
Yeah, any question?
Oh.
Okay, I think I can continue. Now let's see the sample item. Oil gas tar and water gas tar are seldom produced for heating and lighting today because of other sources supply energy for those purposes. Okay, so because of, okay, it's not correct. We use because, okay, should be because, okay, right. Okay, so now I will kind of see first. Okay, let's continue with noun clauses, everyone. I will share my screen. Okay, so before we have discussed adjective clause, adverb clause, and now we do a noun clause, okay? A noun clause is a dependent clause that substitutes a noun. Nah, kalau tadi perbedaan adjective clause dan noun clause, kalau adjective clause digunakan untuk modify noun, untuk menjelaskan lebih lanjut, memberikan keterangan lebih lanjut kalau noun itu apa sih. Sedangkan noun clauses ini digunakan untuk menggantikan noun tersebut, ya, in the main clause, di induk kalimat. Ya, di induk kalimat, berguna sebagai subject or subject complement after a linking verb ya. Jadi kita lihat fungsi fungsinya, kita lihat di bawah ya. Jadi bisa untuk yes no questions, all WH questions here. Oke, kita lihat contohnya ya. Complement of a verb. Complement itu sebagai pelengkap ya. Sebagai subject ya, sebagai verb. Sebagai preposition atau accusative. Nah, mungkin kalian masih ingat accusative kemarin itu untuk menjelaskan dua. Tapi di sini, kalau noun clause digantikan sebagai accusative, dia tidak perlu pakai koma. Beda sama yang pertemuan lalu. Ya. Kita lihat yang subject dulu ya. As subject. Whether he is coming doesn't concern me. Why she committed the crime is being investigated. Ya. Why? Ya, itu untuk reason ya. Whether is ini untuk sebagai subject ya. Nah, as subject complement. The question is when the test results will be announced. She became what she had wanted to become. Okay. Jadi di sini penggunaan when ya, when the test results will be announced ya, kapan ya? Pertanyaan adalah kapan hasilnya itu diumumkan. She became what she had wanted to become. Dia itu menjadi apa yang dia. Oke, bagus. She became what she had wanted to become. Dia itu menjadi apa ya, apa yang dia ingin untuk menjadi. Jadi what-nya ya, what di sini untuk sebagai pelengkapnya is dan became. Jadi complement tadi itu linking verb ya, mungkin misalnya sudah pernah bagikan linking verb itu apa aja. Linking verb itu to be dan juga verb yang digunakan sebagai panca indera seperti became, feel, taste ya. Kalau verb ya, as object of a verb kita bisa pakai that and which. The teacher knew that the students had finished their work. I couldn't decide which shirt I wanted to buy. Mother was concerned about how I would get home. Most of what I know may not be new to you. His belief that air travel is enjoyable is not always correct. The question whether he would marry her was unanswered. Okay. Nah, penggunaan introductory words untuk noun clause di sini, kita bisa pakai yes, no, questions, whether, atau if, dari statement that, atau menggunakan WH question, ya, 5W, 1H. Ya. What, where, which, whose, why, when, or what kind, and how, or much, how long. I think I will move on to the strategy. Okay, misalnya akan langsung ke strategi karena kalau penjelasan ini mungkin kalian agak bingung, tapi kalau kita lihat strateginya kita bisa lihat. Nah, yang Miss Amel bisa sampaikan di sini ya. Walaupun di sini WH question, kalau kalian nemukan WH question di sini, tapi kalian harus tahu di sini bukan pertanyaan tapi pernyataan ya. Kita lihat contohnya ya. Kita lihat strateginya dulu ya. I don't think that her own talent she realizes. Okay, so di sini Miss Amel akan underline dulu the noun clauses ya. Ya. Di sini noun clauses-nya yang ini. Setelah that, ya. Nah, tapi di sini kurang tepat karena posisinya terbalik ya. So it should be I don't think that. Kurang tepat karena posisinya terbalik ya. Jadi kita posisikan sebagai I don't think that she realizes ya, yeah, she realizes her own talents ya, yeah, seperti itu dipindah tempatnya ya. Yeah. Karena di sini menjelaskan bahwa dia tidak tahu ya, yeah, kalau dia itu aku tidak tahu kalau dia itu sadar dengan bakatnya ya, yeah, seperti itu. Oke. Okay. Number two, do you know that will David call you? Yeah. The noun clauses here is this one. Nah, di sini noun clauses-nya setelah that, tapi di sini juga kurang tepat, ya. Yeah. Karena yang ditanyakan adalah bukan will David call you, tapi yang do you know. Ya, yeah, kalau kalian ditanya do you know that will David call you? Kalian jawabnya adalah yes no ya, yes or no. Jadi kita ganti yang will David call you dengan pernyataan ya. Do you know that David will call you, seperti ini ya. Jadi diubah karena pertanyaannya itu bukan di will David call you tapi di do you know. Ya, di situ pertanyaannya ya. Nah, sekarang kita continue ke nomor 3. It is obvious that he hasn't heard the news. Noun clauses-nya adalah he hasn't heard the news. Nah, di sini nomor 3 konsepnya sama seperti nomor 1. Kita harus setelah that kita harus masukkan subject dan verb-nya. Ya, jadi seperti compound sentence kemarin one subject and one verb. Jadi kita bisa simpulkan untuk nomor 3 jawabannya betul. Ya. Next, kita ke nomor 4. I don't know what are you talking about. The noun clause is this one. Ya. Dan konsepnya sama seperti nomor 2. Yang dinyatakan adalah I do not know. Yang dinyatakan adalah saya tidak tahu apa yang kamu bicarakan. Tapi kita harus ubah bukan sebagai pertanyaan tapi pernyataan. Jadi kita ganti dengan what you are, very good, what you are talking about. Okay. Now let's move on with the last number, number 5. The question is, how can we get out of this room? So The noun clause is how, can we get out of this room? The concept is still the same like number four and number two. So is it correct or not, everyone? So I guess I will give the last
correct.
One. Incorrect. So how do we change it? The question is
how we can get out of this room.
Very good. Is how we can. Ya, jadi seperti kembali ke konsep nomor 4 dan 5. Ini bukan pertanyaan tapi pernyataan, ya. Wait. No. Wait, wait. What happened? Okay, so it's this one. I guess I'm wait, how do I Okay, how we can get out of this room. Ya, jadi noun clause itu ya sebenarnya untuk kalau kalian lihat garis besarnya itu pertanyaan yang diubah jadi pernyataan. Ya, kalau noun clause itu yang kalian bisa lihat tuh garis besarnya seperti itu ya. Pernyataan. Jadi bukan pertanyaan ya, seperti itu. Nah, sekarang kita lihat sample itemnya dulu ya. By noting the time, ya. The time lapse from the setting of a whistle blast to the reception of the echo from shore, a mariner can determine roughly how far off the coast is. Ya, jadi nomor sample item 1 yang benar jawabannya adalah yang B. Kenapa? Karena ini sebagai kalimat. Nah, kalau yang A ini masih pertanyaan karena is-nya diletakkan sebelum noun. Ya. Yang ini juga is-nya diletakkan sebelum noun, tapi yang ini juga kurang tepat karena kita belum meletakkan noun clause-nya, how far. Ya, seperti itu ya. Jadi untuk yang sample item 1 kita harus meletakkan noun clause-nya, konektornya how far off baru noun clause-nya yang betul ya, subject dan verb, the coast is ya. Kita lanjutkan dulu untuk nomor strategi 2. Use correct introductory words for noun clauses. Ya, mungkin nanti kalian milih whether atau yang how far yang seperti itu ya. Kita coba dulu. Let's go with strategy 2. I've just found out that my old pants still fit me fine. Ya. Di sini konektornya adalah, jadi kita lihat konektornya dulu aja deh ya. Konektornya adalah yang I've just found out that my old pants still fit me fine. Ya. So which one is it? Bisa dinyalakan nggak apa-apa, yang ini voluntarily aja ya. Yang konektornya dulu, yang konektor. Jadi yang konektornya mana? Yang buat nyambunginnya. I've just found out that my old pants still fit me fine. Yang mana? Konektornya dulu, kita cari konektor yang kata sambungnya dulu. That, very good.
That.
Very good, everyone. Kalau noun clause-nya mana? Which one is the noun clause? Yang tadi kalimat panjang itu. Which one? I've just found out that my old pants still fit me fine. Is it I've just found out or my old pants still fit me fine?
My pants
actually. Jadi semuanya itu setelah ya, setelah konektornya ya. After the connector. Tadi kan kalau adjective clause itu kita fokus di sebelumnya ya, sebelum kalimat, tapi ini fokus setelahnya. Nah, sekarang kita lihat jenis kalimatnya. Apakah sudah benar subject and verb? Pernyataan. Apakah sudah benar? Subjek dulu baru verb. Untuk nomor satu, apakah sudah benar ya, Priman? Is it already correct?
Correct.
Yes, it's already correct. Ya, ini sudah benar karena untuk menyatakan subjeknya adalah my old pants ya, still fit. Verb-nya, ya. Now let's move on to the next number, number two. The announcement what all students passed made the parents happy. Yep. Okay, which one is the connector, everyone? Connectornya dulu. Connectornya yang mana?
What?
What? Okay. Which one is the noun clause?
Student past made.
Made the parents. Okay, so it's the long one. I need to draw with the this one. Okay, make the parents happy. Okay, so is it correct or not? So I want you to pay attention to the connector and also the noun clause. Is it correct or not? Coba sekarang kalian perhatikan kedua-duanya. Itu sudah betul atau salah? Konektornya apakah sudah betul? Konektornya dulu deh yang dilingkarin. Sorry.
Incorrect.
Incorrect. Okay. How about the noun clause? Noun clause-nya is it already correct or not?
Correct, miss.
It's already correct. It's already correct. So how do we change the connector? Jadi bagaimana kita ganti what itu dengan
that or which?
That or which, yeah? Okay, very good. That or which. Good. Good job. Okay, good. Okay. Sekarang kita lihat ya untuk nomor 3. Ya, untuk nomor 3 ini untuk question penggunaan whether dan if. So which one is the connector, everyone? Konektornya yang mana?
Will.
Are you sure, Will?
Check in.
I wonder if Jack will be.
No.
If, very good. If. So which one is the noun clause? I wonder if Jack will be in charge of the next project. Which one is the noun clause? Noun clause-nya sekarang yang mana? Which one is it? Tadi if-nya sudah ya. Noun clause-nya otomatis yang sebelahnya ya. Jack will be
in charge
of the next project. Good job. So is it already correct or not? Sekarang kalian lihat kalimatnya ya, noun clause-nya dan juga if-nya. Is it already correct, everyone? It's already correct, ya. Yeah, it's already correct.
Yes.
Karena di sini Jack subject verb. If itu I wonder. Jadi aku mengira-ngira jika ya. If itu jika ya. Jadi masih mengira-ngira ya. Okay. Now how about number 4? Which one is the connector? Very easy there. Your idea of what your blind date looks like is too exaggerated. What? Yeah. Yes, the idea of, and this is the noun clause. Okay. Your blind date looks like is too exaggerated. Is it correct or not? Jadi idemu soal kencan buta itu terlalu berlebihan. Is it already correct?
Correct, miss.
It's already correct. Okay, it's already correct. Ya, jadi what ini untuk ditujukan blinded, bentukan blinded-nya dia itu kayak apa, ya? Now, let's move on to the last number. So, which one is the connector?
What?
Okay. So, the noun clause is
fire.
The fire started. Okay, is it correct or not? I'm still confused about what the fire started. Okay.
Incorrect.
So it's supposed to be. So the
why?
Connector. About
how? How?
It can be
how
what?
Or why?
I'm still confused about. I want you to focus on the noun clause. The fire started. Ya, dimulai. Kalau dimulai itu biasanya untuk reason or how or when.
How?
Jadi bagaimana ya? Bagaimana bisa menyala ya apinya, entah itu dari konsleting atau dari apa ya, seperti itu ya. I'm still confused about how the fire started. Okay? Ada yang mau ditanyakan mungkin dari yang ini. Untuk noun clause ini sebenarnya untuk diperhatikan itu pertama ya, noun clause-nya ya, yang Miss Amel garis bawahi, noun clause-nya itu kalian harus menulisnya seperti kalimat pernyataan ya, bukan pertanyaan. Jadi subject dan verb ya, subject dan verb, baru nanti yang kedua kalian perhatikan konektornya apakah sudah betul ya. Pakai that, atau pakai which, atau pakai how. Seperti itu ya. Ada yang mau ditanyakan dulu mungkin?
No, miss.
Okay, so Miss Amel will clear all first. Oh, sorry, have you a screenshot, everyone? Have you see?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay, so I will clear all first. Okay, I will see. Is it already exercise? Okay. Scientists estimate how. Okay, it should be that, yeah, that during the, okay. So estimate that. Okay, jadi pakai that, yeah. Okay, so we still have time. So I guess we still have time to play Kahoot, yeah, as usual. Everyone, I want you to go to kahoot.it, okay, on your cell phone, okay, on your smartphone. Okay. Let's play. So I've already ejected pause and left pause. Okay, please join. So there are 11 of you. Okay, 11 participants, including me. This is the game pin. Game pin. Okay, you please use your smartphone for this. Okay. Thank you, Habibi. Thank you, Bagastio.
Ternyata ya banyak temennya, apa temen yang suka pergi-pergi.
Lia, Rizal Fatur. I'm curious with Brian's name. Before Brian used Brian Bule, Brian Brian Immigrant, Brian Brian. Now, what name will you use to show that you are from other country? Mm-mm. I think we can still have a quick play. Okay. Fajar, thank you. Okay, I'm Rizal Duyan. Okay, Brian England. Tomorrow use Brian Scotland, okay? And Ireland or Brian American.
Yes, yes. Very different name.
Good. Ah, Findel, okay. So with how many of you? Sulaiman, Alvinda, Rizal. Rizal, I think got cut off.
Three more miss.
Yeah, but Hamid, yeah, Hamid, focus. Wait, Rizal, we before got cut off, yeah. Guess two more, Hamid and Hamid and Alvin. Alvin? Okay, I guess we can start now, okay?
Okay, miss.
Oh, very good, everyone. Which contains, remember, if you use which, yeah. Sorry, that contains, sorry, that contains, ya. Yeah. Jadi setelahnya itu tidak usah pakai subjek lagi, ya. Yeah. Langsung verb, ya. Yeah. Seperti yang tadi. Very good. So, who's the first? Oh, Rizal, Fatur. Okay, let's go to the next one. Remember, it's still adjective clause, everyone. Jadi diingat ini masih adjective clause ya, yang awal. Oh, nice work, everyone. Who was, ya? Jadi, who and verb. Ya, kenapa who? Karena di sini dia sebagai subjek, ya. Dijelaskan bahwa dia itu seorang penyair dari Inggris, ya, England, just like Brian, in London, England, earn his living mainly by writing reviews, ya. Jadi, dia ini juga sebagai mendapatkan, ya, pendapatan hidupnya dari menulis review. Good job. Good. Oh, wow. Everyone goes up, but these are still up there. Number three. Ini agak sedikit hati-hati ya. agak terjebak ya. Hati-hati ya. Jadi ini misalnya tadi mau jelaskan sedikit. Jadi agak hati-hati ya. Jadi di sini the noted artist Thomas Eakins had a student named Henry Osawa Tanner whom he encouraged to paint professionally. Jadi di sini yang jelaskan adalah si Henry Osawa Tanner. Mohon diingat kalau whom itu setelahnya adalah pronouns ya. Nah, mungkin kalian agak sedikit terjebak dengan whom dan who di sini karena di sini yang jelaskan adalah Henry Osawa Tanner. Nah, Henry Osawa Tanner di sini ini sebagai objek atau subjek? Objek ya. Nah, subjeknya kan si Thomas, objeknya Henry ya. Oh, no. Okay. Let's move on. Okay, so this one choose the incorrect answer. Jadi, pilih yang salah ya, yang ini. Very good. Not what, but diganti dengan apa? Torium. Diganti dengan apa? Kita ganti, bisa kita ganti dengan which or that. Ya, karena torium ini kan benda, chemical element. Oke, okay, you got the correct one. Oh, good job. Result. Still result. Oke, okay, number five. Nice work, everyone. It's not whom, but diganti dengan apa? Bukan whom ya, karena whom itu orang. Karena di sini kita attacks, ya. Kita ganti which or that, oke? Okay. Ooh, Sulaiman. Number six, you have six more. Tapir, tapir ya ini hewan tapir. Good job. It's not which, but where. Oke, okay, jadi bukan which, tapi where. Karena mohon diingat-ingat depths of the forest and near water, location or place. Oke. Okay? Oh wow, wow, going up. Bagas, Aulia, and Hamidi. Ini coba diperhatikan baik-baik kalimatnya ya, the ex removed from a woman. Okay, so the correct one is where. Kenapa diganti where? Karena X ya, atau rahimnya wanita itu diambil ya, remove, and then taken to where, jadi diletakkan di sebuah tempat ya, where they will be left for 6 hours. Jadi diletakkan di sebuah tempat lalu dibiarkan selama 6 jam. Jadi kan sudah di diambil lalu diletakkan ya, in vitro fertilization, jadi di tempatnya ya. Ah, wow, lihat, good. This is adverb clause. Whenever, okay? Why do we choose whenever? According to folklore, the people in the city of Taranto dance tarantella whenever they were bitten by the tarantula spider. Okay? Jadi ini adverb clause of time. Jadi setiap saat mereka digigit, ya, bukan because of, ya, because of, whoever itu bukan, karena whoever, ya, kan tarantula spider itu juga bukan manusia, ya, whatever itu juga bukan, ya. Ah, wow, oke, okay, nice. Be careful with this one, okay? Okay, because, okay, this is adverb clause of reason, okay, because, jadi avoid using because of and due to, okay. Oh, okay, wow, everyone is like racing here. Okay, this one is choose the incorrect. Good job. When? So we change it into where, because Miss Amel has explained before, lies, ya. Jadi lies itu terletak, ya. Jadi kita tidak pakai when, tapi pakai where, ya. Okay, next. Very good. Before, okay? Not before, but when, okay? Jadi bukan sebelum, tapi ketika, ya. Kalau sebelum kan aneh. Okay, I think last number. Oh wow, still up there, Rizal. Nice work, for Sulaiman and Asa. You're like racing there. Nice work. Okay, remember, avoid using because of. Just use because or since or as. Okay, let's see. So who's the third? 10 out of 12. Aulia, good. I think you've been on the podium, Sulaiman. Okay, 10 out of 12. And this is, I guess, Rizal. Okay, Good job. And fourth place is Habibi and Brian. Okay. Good job, everyone. Thank you for playing. Okay, I will find this stop share. Okay, good job, everyone. All right, wait. Okay, nice work. Good job for today, everyone. All right, so now, oh, we'll look at the time. Okay, wait.